Hey, this is Jake Akervik. I'm the communication coordinator with Minnesota Department of Transportation Research Services. I'm here with Tom Wood. He's a research project supervisor with the MnDOT Office of Materials and Road Research. And we're here today to talk about a project and topic, preventive trail maintenance. Tom, you want to talk a little bit about the project and topic and tell us why it's important and why you did the project?
Okay, thanks, Jake. Yeah, 2 or 3 years ago, a group of us got together and we realized that in Minnesota we had a lot of recreational trails. These were city, county, and state trails. And these trails have numerous users. They have everywhere from the recreational walker, which I'm happy to be one, to the rollerbladers, the fitness trainers, to the people that are commuting. It's amazing how many people use these trails to commute to work. With the high cost of gas and the concern for the environment, it's growing. One of the sad things we noticed was that people were building new trails every year, but they were forgetting them. And trails suffer more from environmental aging than roadways do because they do not have traffic on them to need them and keep them alive. So basically, they were building the trails and the ultraviolet light and the sunlight and everything was deteriorating them and they were failing. And trails are very expensive to build because of limited access. You can see behind me that this trail was very beautiful going down through the woods, but in order to get a paver in there, it's very difficult and very expensive. So we got together and we said, hey, we need to look at, can we maintain our trails? Can we do preventative maintenance to maintain our trails? In other words, can we give our trail an oil change like you do your car? And so we got together and started the project, and what we did is we looked at what was currently being done, and we were looking at what we were doing on the streets and seeing if we could modify them. Some of the things we looked at was chip sealing, which we do regularly on a street, and that's a heavy asphalt layer of binder followed by a layer of rock. And we found that that worked very well to extend the life of a trail. But the problem is, if you're not careful with the size of rock, if you use too big a rock, it gives you a texture that the rollerbladers don't like. It makes their feet go to sleep. So we found out we had to modify the size of rock. We had to go to a smaller rock to give a smoother surface to be acceptable to all the users. The next thing we looked at is fog sealing. And fog sealing is similar to spraying a layer of paint on your wood siding on your house. And it's basically you spray an asphalt emulsion on there and it cures and it paints black. And what that layer does, that film protects the surface of the trail from the ultraviolet light and for oxidation and all those things there, and it was very cost effective. And then we also looked at crack sealing, and we found that any of these things you do will extend the life of your trail. We also found that if you start your preventive maintenance right when you build the trail and you do it on a regular cycle, you're going to get the most bang for the buck. And another way to save money we found is if you're doing a chip seal on your city street and you've got trails along it, and you're contracting your chip seal for your streets, include your trail in that chip seal contract, and it adds volume to the contract and you get a better price for not only your street but also your trail.
Tom, can you talk a little bit about there's some national interest in this project?
Okay, yeah, it's really been fun. One of the key goals of this project, beside looking at the treatments and the methods, was to raise the awareness that we had to do preventive maintenance for trails. Trails were forgotten, and it's been fun since the report's been published. We've had numerous states call us up asking for information about what we're doing. We've been asked to talk at numerous conferences about it. And what's even going to be more fun is that we've got an implementation project coming up where we're going to take the findings of this study and develop a short class for the practitioners to use to figure out how to maintain their trails, which is going to raise the awareness. The technical advisor on this project asked me right when we were finishing up if we had accomplished our goals, and I told him, I said, the biggest goal was, in my opinion, was to raise the awareness that we have all these thousands of miles of trails that are dying from environmental death, that by as simple as doing an oil change, in other words, preventative maintenance, we can extend their life 15, 20 years longer than what it would normally be.
Tom, can you talk a little bit about why implementation is important for research projects?
Implementation, to me, is a key for research. For years, people, colleges, research offices have done research projects and they end up sitting on the shelf and nobody knows about the findings. And the best research in the world has no value unless you share it with the people that need to know the information. And the key to share it is numerous ways, by doing presentations, by doing training with it and publication and even little short videos like this.
Okay, it's great, Tom. We appreciate you talking about the topic. If you need more information, you can find information about the project, contact information on the LRRB's website at www.lrrb.org. You can also find information on the MnDOT Research website at research.dot.state.mn.us. Thanks, Tom.
Thank you, Jake. Have a good day.
You too.